Blackstone presents Mavey and Beth's Double Act, Book 1, Where's My Whistle? By Kristy Nita Brown. Read by Sarah Bacaller. Chapter 1. Today is Monday. I love Mondays because music class is on Monday. But today I nibble my toast slowly before school. My stomach churns. I am worried. Last week in music class, Miss Harmony said, "Practice your whistling, please. Next week you will learn a new song, and it has whistling in it." Then Miss Harmony said we will sing and whistle this song at the end of year concert. My sister Beth can whistle, loudly, but I can't whistle at all. What am I going to do? The end of year concert is the biggest of all the concerts. Today is Mum's day to walk us to school. On the way, I bite my nails. "Mavey, you're quiet today," Mum says. "Is everything all right?" I stop biting my nails and nod. "I'm always quiet. Mum says I'm just shy. My sister Beth is very loud. She's also funny. I'm glad that Beth is very loud and funny because she makes me laugh." "Mavey, what are hundreds and thousands?" Beth asks me.
Little coloured sprinkles on cupcakes," I say.
"No, silly," she says, skipping next to me. "They're M&M poos!" I imagine a blue chocolate M&M on a tiny toilet, huffing and puffing. Then a teeny-weeny, bright pink 100,000 drops into the toilet water. Plop! Beth's joke makes me laugh with all of my body. Mum gives a heavy sigh. Beth ignores Mum and holds my hand. We skip together. Our school bags skip together too, on our backs. When we arrive at the school gate, I drop Beth's hand. My heart drops with it, because music class is first, and I still can't whistle. When Mum catches up, she kneels down next to us. Taking a quick glance, she checks the other parents can't hear her. Then she gives my sister some tips about how to be good. "Beth, don't tell any poo jokes. Poo jokes aren't nice."
"But Mum," Beth complains loudly, "all the kids tell poo jokes. That's what year twos do."
For a moment, Mum stares at Beth, then at me. Shaking her head, she says, "What am I going to do with you two?"
"Increase our pocket money," Beth says quickly.
Mum laughs and pulls us in tight for a twin hug. As we walk into school, Mum waves goodbye like she's waving a million birthday candles out with her hands. Then she yells out, "Make smart decisions!" I smile and wave back, but I don't really know what she means. When Beth and I get to class, we hang our bags up on our hooks. Even though we're in the same class, my hook is ages away from Beth's. Her hook is near the classroom door. My hook is closer to the boys' toilet. Yuck! I think our teacher labelled the hooks in alphabetical order. Ava's hook is the first hook, and Woody's hook is the last. Woody's hook is almost in the toilet. Double yuck. The school bell rings. Oh, I clutch my belly. It feels like little fish are darting around inside it. What if everyone laughs at me because I can't whistle? What if Miss Harmony says I can't perform at the concert? Chapter 2. After school, Dad is waiting for us at the school gate. On the walk home, Beth tells Dad about our day. First, who we played with at recess. Second, who we played with at lunch. Third, who had the best snacks in their lunchbox. And fourth, how the year threes were being annoying, again. "They think they own the monkey bars. Everyone should get a turn." Then Beth tells Dad about Ava's new sparkly gold sneakers.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.